Welcome, everyone, to this wonderful celebration, the sacrament of matrimony. We begin as we begin all good things in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Such a joy and blessing to be here this evening to celebrate this sacrament with you. It's wonderful that you're here to support Angelo, Adriana. Beautiful. Thank you, wedding party. Just fantastic. We had rehearsal last night. This is the best wedding party ever. And so let us begin. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Angelo and Adriana, the church welcomes you with great joy, together with your families and friends, as today in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this joyful day. May he send you help from heaven to protect you. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these your servants, Angelo and Adriana, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now we'll have the liturgy of the word.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Then God said, "Let us make human beings in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, the tame animals, all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the earth." God created mankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that crawl in the earth." God looked at everything he had made and found it very good. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. Let love be sincere. Hate what is evil, hold on to what is good, love one another with mutual affection, anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal, be fervent in spirit, serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope, endure in affliction, persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the holy ones, exercise hospitality. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. We praise the God who brings us joy, who brings families together, and keeps them safe on their journey back to his kingdom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
One of the Pharisees, a scholar of the law, tested Jesus by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please have a seat.
I love your earrings, too.
So, I'm going to have a chat with these two. You're, feel free to listen in if you'd like. So here we are. Mm-hmm. Got to tell you, this is a blessing. And you know, we're celebrating what's most important today. That's why we're all here. We're dressed in our best. But I got to say, Nobody compares to you, Adriana. You look stunning. Absolutely gorgeous. And Angie, who knew? You clean up so well. Very, very impressive. But you know what? As great as you two look, and you could be models, we saw the picture last night of you two kissing, it's like, what the heck? Gorgeous. That's not what's most important. You guys are medical professionals. You've really worked hard to get to where you are. You've set yourselves up, after a few student loans, I'm sure, but you've set yourself up for long-term financial success. Guess what? It's not what's most important. And I hear that after this ceremony, there's a great party. That's not what's most important. So if it's not how you look, and it's not how much you make, and it's not the party, then what is most important about today? And it's the covenant. Now, a covenant is different than a contract. A contract is an agreement to exchange goods. You pay so much money, you buy a car, you buy a house, you buy a wedding dress, you rent a tux. That's a contract. But a covenant is way different. A covenant is an exchange of persons. When God made a covenant, he would say, you will be my people and I will be your God. And in like way, today, Adriana, you're going to say, you will be my husband, I will be your wife. And Ed, you will be my wife and I will be your husband. There is this exchange of persons, this exchange of commitment. And that's why, I hate to break this to you at the last moment, I can't marry you today. If Father Zapata was here, he couldn't marry you today. The bishop, he can't do it. The pope, nope. The only ones who can marry you today are you. The sacrament of matrimony is the only sacrament in the church where the recipients of the sacrament convicted on themselves. Because I can't give you to anybody. And I can't give you to anybody. The only one that can do that is you. And is you. And so today, we celebrate a gift. The gift of you giving yourselves totally and unconditionally to one another. That's the power of this covenant. And it is this covenant that is the foundation of everything else that's going to happen. Today, you are going to say these words, that I will love you and honor you for the rest of my life. That's a big commitment. And what underlies that commitment is humility. Humility is the willingness to lift up the other and subservient yourself. It is the willingness for you to go low so that you can lift up your beloved. And you know what? You two had like the most elegant example of that in your lives when you got engaged. And you went down on one knee, completely lowering yourself to Adriana. And your question lifted her up and filled her with joy. And Adriana, your answer lifted him up physically and spiritually. Use that as the metaphor for the rest of your lives, because marriage is all about this dynamic cycle of sharing and supporting and loving and giving in humility. And that humility is essential for everything that's going to happen going forward. Your covenant lives and breathes and gets strengthened based on your willingness to be humble to one another. That contract? A covenant of free gift, of freely willing to humble yourselves to one another. So what's the importance of this covenant? Well, it becomes the foundation of everything that you do. And the fact that you came here means that you added an element to your covenant that takes it to a whole different level. It makes it part of something immensely bigger than all of us. And that is, you came before Christ. And you have invited him into your covenant. And because of that, he recognizes the great gift of love that you have for each other and that willingness to love him as much as he loves you. And now we bring this all together. So that covenant sits here. It actually touches every element of your lives. It will set you up for how you decide and how you plan, for the things that you decide are important and those things that are not. It sets up how you're going to parent. It sets up how you're going to argue. It sets up how you're going to ask for forgiveness and how you're going to forgive. It sets up how you're going to sacrifice for each other, for your children, for your family. In a word, it is the foundation for how you love. And that's the call. That's what you're entering into today. So if the covenant is not central to your marriage, then guess what? Doesn't matter how many nice clothes you got. Doesn't matter how much money you got. Doesn't matter how many great parties you throw. It just won't matter, because it's not all that important. There are thousands of people that come to altars every year that are in the exact same place you are, that will say the words that you're going to say, but they weren't willing to do the work to make their covenant come together and get strengthened. That's the call for you today, is to recognize that. But because here's the thing, a lot of people don't realize that love is work. Love is hard work. Having said that, however, just understand this. The chances of you two coming together, if you start from Adam and Eve, all the things that had to happen in order for this day to happen, it's probably like a trillion, trillion, trillion to one. You are not an accident. You are an on purpose. God planned your covenant from the beginning of time. It was essential to his plan. And his plan would be less perfect without you two and the commitment you're about to make to each other. You two are some of his best work. So here we go. We take this time now and we reflect, because it is through and in God's love that you're able to give yourselves to one another fully, authentically, unconditionally. Not as an acquisition, you are mine, but as gift, I am yours. And that is what's most important about today. You ready to get married?
Yeah.
Come on up. Bridal party, if you would join us up here. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament. He enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated in holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. I have. Angelo and Adriana, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared to enter the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I am.
Beautiful. Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, I now ask you to face each other, join your right hands, and declare your consent before God and his church. Andrew first. Mm-hmm. I, Angelo, take you, Adriana, to be my wife.
I, Angelo, take you, Adriana, to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Adriana. I, Adriana. I, Adriana, take you, Angelo, to be my husband.
I, Adriana, take you, Angelo, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
And in sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you all the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God has joined together, let no one separate. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Adriana.
Adriana.
Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Beautiful.
Almost didn't fit there.
Okay, ready? Angelo.
Angelo.
Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Put it on the screen. There we go. There we go. Okay. So, you guys can go back. You guys are going to do the candles.
Okay. Perfect.
One of the beautiful parts of the marriage rite is something called the nuptial blessing. And so if you would join hands. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image, and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you, for these your servants who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down on this bride Adriana and upon Angelo, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord, and in sorrow may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in all their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the holy assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with our circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So if I could ask everyone to please stand. You know, with every sacrament, we always say the Lord's Prayer, reminding us of the great blessing that Christ gave us by changing our relationship with God from Creator to Father. And so together, and what I would ask is, let's say it genuinely, authentically, and slowly, together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, you are the foundation and source and perfection of the family. We ask that today and all days for the rest of their lives, you bless Angelo and Adriana as they become your children in service to one another and in service to you and your church. We ask that you continue to be with them, guide them and strengthen them, surround them with strong family and friends, and bring them safely into your kingdom. We ask this as we ask all things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, descend upon us all and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Okay, you guys can turn around. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to be able to introduce to you for the very first time Dr. and Mrs. Angelo Riccione.
Okay, guys. God bless you.
Thank you.
Check us out.
All right. All I see are angels and all these streets of gold that lead to you. If touching love is touching God, no wonder I'm in heaven when I'm holding you. Simple as a song, a melody repeating in this heart. I don't know when the chorus came, where I heard it first, but when it started. I won't be holding my breath for chariots. I'm not just waiting for skies to part. You've been my glimpse of kingdom right from the start. And you got me touching heaven. Ooh, 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 ooh. Got me touching heaven.
What you're dreaming, tell me what it is. Your dream come true. I don't need a map to find a hidden treasure that ain't no hiding you.
I won't be holding my breath for chariots. I'm not just waiting for skies to part. You've been my glimpse of kingdom right from start. And you got me touching heaven. Ooh, 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 ooh. Got me touching heaven. Ooh, 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 ooh. Got me touching heaven. And you're my hallelujah. You're my hallelujah. Yes, you are.
You're my hallelujah.
Oh, you're my hallelujah. Yes, you are.
Hallelujah. Oh, you're my hallelujah.
Oh,
you're my hallelujah.
This has been. I didn't think it would ever get here, and it finally has. And now it's sort of slipping away, but not before we celebrate. I just have a few things I want to say, and the first is thank you all for coming. Thank you all of you who are Adriana's friends. Thank you all who are our friends, and thank you all Angelo's friends, and of course his family. God. And I've and Mary and I have been getting to know them this the past few days, and it's been great. So we know it's a long way, and some of them came from California, some of them came from Seattle, some from upstate New York, I believe Buffalo and Rochester, from Philadelphia. And Maryland. Don't forget Maryland. So I hope I didn't forget it. Yeah. And I just have one thing I want to say to Adriana right now, because most of the things I like to say to her are private and personal, but the one thing I'm going to say to you right now in front of everyone is that your world is going to get an awful lot larger. And I just have one thing that I'm going to say to Angelo, and he's heard it before too, and I've talked to Marion about this, and Angelo, you know, returns are not acceptable. I just want to say I'm so happy for both of you, and I wish all the world and all the love, and it's just been great. Thank you very much.
It was great. Never give a preacher a microphone, right, John? I'm just here to offer prayer before dinner. But first, I have to just say congratulations to both of you. When Deacon John said you were both model-esque, it's so true. But what I will say is that you are models for all of us in terms of the way you expressed your love, the way you behave, except for that silliness that you have, of course, there. But we wish all the best for you. So let us again remember that we are always in the presence of our Lord. And we be in our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good and gracious God, we thank you so much for these two lives that have come together to be one today. We pray that you will bless them richly in everything that they do. And they should have at least as many kids as their Aunt Dennis, their Aunt Barbara and Dennis had. Seven. We pray, Lord Jesus Christ, that you will bless them always in everything that they do. That, Lord, that you will always be with them, that you will always be a presence in their home and in their lives, and that they may spread your light wherever they go and whatever they do and whoever they meet and whoever they touch, whether it's be in their medical practices or in their friendships or in their family, or in any of those things that they do, that Jesus may always be a light in their eyes and a light in their marriage. And because we're about to have dinner, we thank you, Lord, for the food that we're about to receive. We pray for those who don't have enough food, who don't have enough clean water, don't have enough clothing and our place to stay, place to live, that they too may share in your bounty. We offer all of these blessings and all of these thanks in your name, Jesus Christ. Can I hear amen? Amen. Amen.
Those who don't know me, I'm Nick. I'm the closest sibling in age to Ange. I'm his younger brother. I was the annoying little brother that always wanted to be like Ange when I grew up. Wanted to be taller. That never happened. My mom would actually dress us up in the same clothes. I loved it. Ange hated it. I think him becoming a doctor and moving to Texas were just things that, you know, I wouldn't copy off of, so you know, cover it. My head's too small for cowboy hats. My feet are almost too wide for cowboy boots, and I say what instead of do what. Adriana, you definitely had numerous chances to leave this guy. Whether it was the bartender at Movie Tavern cutting Ange off, had to be the first time that ever happened. Or him flushing down brawny paper towels down your toilet. That was bad. Don't use those. Or him bringing in two little dogs that are way more destructive than any dog you ever met. With all those, you still found a way to not leave him and kept him and his dog, so thank you. You guys are perfect for each other, so thanks a lot. Adriana, I can honestly say I've never seen anyone this happy. Also, he's completely himself, so thank you. It's always nice having you guys in Texas as well. I mean, I don't think we have seen this much of our family in years, so it's a nice vacation spot, so that's good. I'm also looking forward to having Howard as a nephew, so that'll be good. I love you guys. Have a kid already as well, because then I have another excuse to bring my kid here so we can hang out, so that'll be good. I love you guys. Cheers.
I am not that funny. So on a serious note, my name is Timber Kay, and I have known Adriana since 2012 when we met in nursing school. We were actually assigned to sit together, and ever since then, we have pretty much just hit it off. We've been super close ever since, from studying sessions to just lunch dates, nights out, things like that. And I just feel like we know each other to our core. And I'm so thankful, even when we live hundreds of miles apart, I can still call you and talk to you about my everyday life. And so, you have seen me grow, you have seen my babies grow, we have grown together, we have been through a lot, and we have learned a lot. So, with that being said, her happiness has always been one of my top priorities. From the moment that I knew you guys were together, I could really just tell how much love there was there. And getting this girl to the altar is tricky. So now that we're here, congrats to you because you did it. Okay? You did it. Big task, big accomplishment. I couldn't be happier for you guys. If I could give you any advice, it would really just be to appreciate each other, because it will make you strong. It will make you strong. And at the end of the day, you need to be strong to make it last. So, not as funny, but I love you.
Sincere.
It is sincere. It's from the heart. I'm so nervous, but I love you so much, and I'm so glad to know you. So thankful and so happy for the both of you. And I, now that my notes are done, cheers.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart. Why are we here and where do we go? We're knocking so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. I find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between, with only two, just me and you. Not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Understand my ups and downs. There you were, with sweet love and devotion, deeply touching my emotion. I want to stop. Thank you, baby. I want to stop. And thank you, baby. Yes, I do.
How sweet it is to be loved.
So fine.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
I close my eyes at night, wondering where would I be without you in my life. Everything I did was just a bore. Everywhere I went, it seems I'd been there. Thank you, baby. Oh, yes.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Just like sugar sometimes.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
And how about another round of applause? That's Dr. Riccione. Thanks to the mom. Hey, Adriana, do me a favor and go grab your bag.
You say, what can make me feel this? as it can be, and I need you here with me. When you lift me up, I know that I'll never fall. I can speak to you by saying nothing at all. Every single time I find it harder to breathe, 'cause I need you here with me. Every day as it can be, 'cause I need you here with me every day.